Good morning, students.
We are going to study the chapter poverty. So let us see the topics which we are going to cover within this. That is definition, measures of poverty, categorizing, and determination of poverty line.
Well, this picture has its own story. The picture seems too beautiful. The faces are smiling, but they are living below poverty line. So let's understand the chapter poverty.
Poverty is not an accident like slavery and apartheid. It is man-made and can be removed by the actions of human being. Let's study the poverty chapter.
Okay, students, let's see the definition of the word poverty. Poverty refers to a situation in which individual is unable to fulfill the basic necessities of life. Hence, it is clear from the definition that it is a situation in which one is unable to fulfill his basic requirements of life. A situation where one is not able to feed his family. A situation where one is not able to feed himself. He or she do not have a shelter, housing, clothing. So these are the basic requirements which every human being needs. And if anyone lacks this, hence it is termed as the person is below poverty line or poor. So hope you understand the meaning of poverty. What is poverty? Once again, I will repeat the definition. Poverty refers to a situation in which one is unable to fulfill the basic necessities of his or her life. And the basic necessities are food, clothing, shelter. Nowadays, education is also considered as one of the important necessity of life. So let's see the second point, that is measures of poverty. They are as absolute poverty and relative poverty. So measures of poverty, we are going to study about absolute poverty and relative poverty. Let's see what is absolute poverty and relative poverty. Relative poverty, it refers to the poverty of people in comparison to other people, religion or nation. That means that the person are not actually poor. They are found to be poor when they compare themselves with other people. When a country compare itself with other country, when a region is compared with other region, then that is called relative poverty. That means they can afford to fulfill their basic requirements. They are actually not poor, but relatively they are poor when they. So relatively they are poor when they are being compared. Hence, this is the definition of relative poverty. Now we will see absolute poverty. Absolute poverty actually refers to the total number of people living below poverty line. That means they are those people who cannot afford basic needs of life. They lack food, clothing, shelter, education. They are those people who are actually poor and living below poverty line. Hope the definition of relative and absolute is clear to you all, and the difference is also clear. Once again, relative means they are relatively poor when they are being compared, and an absolute person is absolutely poor. That means a person cannot afford the basic necessities of life. Now we will see poverty line. What is poverty line? Poverty line refers to the line which divides the population into two parts. That means there's a line and it dividing the population into two parts. At one side poor, another side non-poor. In other words, we can say that it is actually cutoff point on the line of distribution. That means it is a line which is bifurcating the category of people. That is one who is living above those line and the other one who is living below the line. The one who is living the above that line are non-poor, and the one who is living below that line are poor. So hope poverty line is clear. We will further study determination of poverty line in our next segment of topic. Before that, we will see the topic categorizing poverty. How the poverty is characterized as? So poverty is categorized as chronic poor, transit poor and non-poor. We are going to see these three kinds of categories of poor. Let us see the very first category, that is chronic poor. Chronic poor are those poor which include always poor as well as usually poor. Now we need to understand what does it mean, always poor and usually poor.
Actually, there are some people who are always poor. That means they cannot afford the basic necessities of their life by working or by earning, because they are not working or earning. So they cannot afford. Usually, poor are those who may sometimes have a little more money. For example, casual workers, they may have some money if they are having a little work with them, but they comes under the category of chronic poor. Churning poor and occasionally poor are the two groups of poor which include transient poor. So we are seeing the second category of poor, that is transient poor. Transient poor refers to churning poor and occasionally poor. Who are the churning poor? Churning poor is another group of people who regularly move in and out of poverty. For example, small farmers and seasonal workers. What happens, sometimes they have work, sometimes they do not have work. So basically, they regularly move in and out of poverty. And the occasionally poor are those who are rich. They are rich, but sometimes due to patch of bad luck or unfortunately, they lose the things. They fall under the category of poor. So they are called transient poor. Basically, they are richer sections of the society. They are rich, but due to some other situation, they may lose the money. They may come under the category where they are not able to afford their basic necessities of life. So they are occasionally poor. And these two categories, churning poor and occasionally poor, is known as transient poor. Non-poor or never poor are those who are never poor. That means they can sustain their living, they can afford to fulfill their basic sustenance or basic necessities of life. Hence, they are categorized as never poor or non-poor. Now we'll see poverty line determination. In pre-independent India, Dadabhai Nauroji was the first person to discuss the concept of poverty line. And he used the menu for a prisoner and used appropriate prevailing prices to arrive at what may be called jail cost of living. So there are various ways of poverty line by which we can measure or determine. So we'll see the poverty line determination. The first is minimum calorie consumption and the second one is minimum consumption expenditure. Let us understand what is minimum calorie consumption and what is minimum consumption expenditure. People living in rural area must consume 2400 calorie and people living in urban area must consume at least 2100 calorie. If people living in rural area consume less than 2400 calorie, that means they are below poverty line. So the minimum requirement of calorie consumption in rural areas is 2400, whereas in urban area it is 2100. If a person is consuming 2100 calorie consumption per day, that means a person is above poverty line. Otherwise, a person is below poverty line. Hence, the set minimum calorie consumption for rural areas is 2400 and for urban areas it is 2100. Now, minimum consumption expenditure. In rural areas, a person must do the consumption expenditure of 860 rupees monthly, that is 32 rupees daily, and in urban areas it must be 1407 rupees monthly, 47 rupees daily. Hence the minimum consumption expenditure requirement for rural areas 860 rupees monthly, that is 32 rupees daily, and for urban areas it is 1407 rupees monthly, that is 47 rupees daily. So we discuss minimum calorie consumption and minimum consumption expenditure. Rest we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.